So, I've been playing Dawn of Man, compulsively, and it's pretty good. I'm serious though, I've been compulsively playing it for weeks now and I can't stop. I have over 20 hours on this stupid game, please send help. Dawn of Man is a strategy, survival, city building, and overall caveman simulator game that takes place during the Pleistocene. In Dawn of Man, you must carefully guide and manage your Paleolithic community through the Stone Age and all the way into the Iron Age. Or if you're from the state of Kentucky, it's a game that takes place during the Antediluvian, and you must guide your community of God-fearing cavemen as you survive against the harsh elements and the roaming descendants of Cain. I really like this game. I'm not even sure where to start. This game just has me completely pegged. You start off with just six little cavemen, and from there you're dumped into the wilderness and expected to not just survive, but thrive, and build an extensive primitive community of Ungas and Bungas. And that's it, my dudes. That's all there is to it, but to do it. But how do you do it exactly? Well, you hunt, you fish, you gather food, you set collection sites for your cavemen to gather resources, and get this, they just go and do it. But to truly advance, you'll have to put the Neo in Neolithic. The game has a tech tree that is unlocked by spending knowledge points. You gain knowledge by completing various tasks or hitting milestones that usually involve gathering resources, building structures, hunting new animals, gaining more population, and just doing things. This game constantly incentivizes expansion and exploration by rewarding you with shiny new tech. Collected 10 quarts of wood? Have a point. Killed your first bear? Have a point. Forced your cavemen to erect an ancient alien standing meme rock? Have a point. As long as you're doing something in the game, you'll be moving forward, and each level of progression dramatically expands gameplay further and your ability to do new things. I can't express in words just how satisfying it is to see my dirt-covered, poo-flinging tent town of Ungabungas advance through the ages and become an Old Testament city of wheat farmers with donkey-pulled wagons and thatched peasant hovels. This game is great. Also, if you're really into Ice Age animals, this game has an entire epoch full of Ice Age animals that you can just genocide for meat and building materials. Mammoths, rhinos, aurochs, bison, lions, and cave bears. The animals even go extinct as you pass through the various ages and get replaced by boring, diminished contemporary creatures. I don't know, I think it's a nice touch worth mentioning. The other great thing about this game is that technological progression isn't strictly necessary for expansion. Do you just want to continue ruling an uncouth gang of ape men and see how far you can expand your community using nothing but rock sticks and feces? Go ahead, poop it up! There's literally an achievement for having a village of 100 people in the Paleolithic era. It's all on you, poop boss. If I had any criticisms to make about this game, though, it'd have to be the lack of unique maps and how annoying combat can be at times. There's two different environments, temperate and arctic, and two maps, by a lake or by a river, and that's literally it. The maps are also not randomly generated, so what the game gives you is what you get, period. Combat can be a pain in the pickle pea, because while you can build aesthetic and cool-ass towers and walls, raiders will tear through anything not made out of stone as if it were paper mache. Walls are good for directing the flow of boogas, but don't make the mistake of thinking water acts as a barrier. Cavemen are prepared to swim across a lake in order to culturally enrich your community. If you're interested in this game, or if you've already played it and would like to play other games like it, Madruga has also made Planet Base, which is like this game, only it takes place on Mars, and you build a self-sufficient colony of bubbles, where the people eat greenhouse vegetables and drink from their dedicated pea jars. I'd also like to recommend you keep an eye on the Kickstarter game Ancient Cities, which is pretty much the exact same game, with the only difference being it's got them big dick graphics and it's never coming out, because it's a Kickstarter game. Dawn of Man is on Steam right now for like 28 Canadian, which in real world dollars is 21 American. So I understand if that's too steep a price for some, but heck, if it goes on sale, why not pick it up? I've gotten 32 hours of play out of it since I got it, and I still love it. With that said, I'm proud to give this game an Ooga out of Booga.